So, I heard you want to make some money. How to invest? For dummies. Now, my job is not to call you a dummy. In fact, I'm unemployed. I don't have a job. What I do have is goals. Which brings us to step one. Figure out what you want. Are you a student with some extra pocket change? Or are you 35 looking to settle down with a family? Know where you are in debt's timeline and adjust your risk accordingly. You're never too old to get started. Trust me, I'm 21. And now that you've got that figured out, it's time to open an investment account. Any of them. It doesn't matter. Robinhood is great. It's super easy to use. It's beautifully designed. And if you use my promo code, you get one free stock. Did that work?
Nope.
Shit. Fidelity is another awesome one. She's a tad boring without a lot of spunk, but way more reliable. And Vanguard is just as good. Okay, moving on to step three. Invest in diversity. And what does diversity mean? Well, it means making friends with people that don't look like you, that don't think like you. It means opening your mind and understanding some other perspectives every once in a while. Diversity also means don't put all your eggs in one basket. You don't know whether a stock is gonna go up or down, so don't pretend like you do, Brian. Study after study after study shows that a random sample of chimpanzees would literally have a better chance at predicting the market than the so-called financial experts, quotation marks needed. What you can do is invest in index funds, which is a collection of a bunch of different stocks that, over the long term, will give you about 10% each year. That means you'll be doubling your money every 7.5 years. Now, this may seem a little bit too easy. So what's the catch? Well, it's boring and not very exciting. You'll be tempted in good times to get cocky and in bad times to sell it all. But don't you press that button. Over the last 15 years, 75 to 90% of all actively managed funds underperformed passive funds. That sucks. That's what people mean when they say don't try to beat the market. If you keep buying in small intervals over the rest of your life, I'd say you did it. You win. So what comes next? You buy some fancier gadgets, you walk in higher fashion, you're making a lot of money. What else could you want? You mingle with the well-off lads and enjoy appetizer after appetizer after appetizer, and slowly, very slowly, you begin to forget what life was like before you had what you have now. You become obsessed with fitting in, spending more time, more money. The number in your bank becomes your identity. You hunger and crave and thirst as you consume and consume and consume, looking for that one thing, that one hit that will make you feel complete. You wake up alone. You look back at where it all went wrong. The day spent working instead of living. Money did not free you. It chained you. The more suffering it inflicted, the tighter grip it held. You were so busy chasing dragons, forgot to breathe and enjoy the moment. But hey, you made a lot of money. What else could you want?